This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Piers Stephen Pugh Morgan, born Piers Stephen O'Meara, the 30th of March 1965, known professionally as Piers Morgan, is a British journalist and television personality currently working as the US editor-at-large for Mail Online. Morgan is the editorial director of First News, a national newspaper for children published in the UK. He began hosting Piers Morgan Live on CNN on the 17th of January 2011. The show replaced Larry King Live in the 9 o'clock. About it. Morgan has written 8 books, including 4 volumes of memoirs. Contents: 1 Early Life, 2 Career, 21 At the Murdoch Titles, 22 Daily Mirror Editor, 23 Post Mirror Press Career, 24 Television, 3 Feuds, 31 Ian Hislop, 32 Jeremy Clarkson, 33 Janet Mock, 34 Band Guests, 4 Phone Hacking Allegations, 5 Personal Life, 6 Books, 7 References, 8 External Links. Early life. Piers Morgan was born Piers Stephen O'Meara on 30 March 1965 in Newark, Sussex, England, to Vincent Eamon O'Meara, an Irish-born dentist, originally from County Offaly, and Gabrielle Georgina Sybil née Oliver. He took his stepfather's surname and became known as Piers Stephen Pugh Morgan. He attended the independent school Cumnor House from the ages of 7 to 13, and then Chailey School, a comprehensive secondary school in Chailey, near Lewes, East Sussex, followed by Priory School for 6th form. Morgan studied journalism at Harlow College. After a brief career at Lloyd's of London, he joined the Surrey and South London newspaper group in 1985, where he worked as a reporter on the South London News and the Streatham and Tooting News. Morgan was recruited, he says, headhunted by editor Kelvin McKenzie to join the Sun, to work on the bizarre column Career at the Murdoch Titles. Morgan's first high-profile post in the British media was as the main writer of Bizarre, the Sun's show business column, while the newspaper was being edited by Kelvin McKenzie. In 1994, aged 29, he was appointed editor of the News of the World by Rupert Murdoch, becoming the youngest national newspaper editor in more than half a century. He quickly gained notice for his prying, forthright style and lack of sympathy for celebrities' privacy, claiming that they could not manipulate the media to further their own ends without accepting the consequences of a two-way deal. Morgan left this post in 1995 shortly after publishing photographs of Catherine Victoria Lockwood, then wife of Charles, Earl Spencer, leaving an addictive disorders clinic in Surrey. This action ran against the editor's code of conduct, a misdemeanor for which the Press Complaints Commission upheld a complaint against Morgan. Murdoch was reported as having said that the boy went too far and publicly distanced himself from the story, fearful of a privacy law action if he had not criticized one of his employees. Murdoch is said to have apologized to Morgan in private. The incident was reported to have contributed to Morgan's decision to leave for the Daily Mirror editorship. Morgan's autobiography The Insider states that he left the News of the World of his own choice and somewhat against owner Rupert Murdoch's wishes when he was offered the job of editor at the Daily Mirror. Daily Mirror editor as editor of the Daily Mirror. In 1996, Morgan was forced to apologize on television for the headline rendered in upper case, "Ich tung surrender. For you Fritz Z Euro Championship is over." On 25 June 1996, a day before England met Germany in a semi-final of the Euro 96. Football Championships, a £16 million package of investment in the title was rolled out from January, including the dropping of Daily from the masthead in February, which was later reversed. Roy Greenslid wrote in August 1999 that Morgan's editorship has made a huge difference, his enormous enthusiasm, determination and focus is a major plus. Morgan was the subject of an investigation in 2000 after Susie Jagger wrote an article for the Daily Telegraph revealing that he had bought £20,000 worth of shares in the computer company Vigeland soon before the Mirror's City Slickers column tipped Vigeland as a good buy. Morgan was found by the Press Complaints Commission to have breached the code of conduct on financial journalism, but kept his job. The City Slickers columnists, Anil Boyrule and James Hipwell, were both found to have committed further breaches of the code and were sacked before the inquiry concluded. Further inquiry by the Department of Trade and Industry in 2004 cleared Morgan of any charges. On 7 December 2005, Boyrule and Hipwell were convicted of conspiracy to breach the Financial Services Act. During the trial, it emerged that Morgan had bought £67,000 worth of Vigeland shares, emptying his bank account and investing under his first wife's name. The Mirror attempted to move mid-market in 2002, claiming to eschew the more trivial stories of show business and gossip. Morgan rehired John Pilger, who had been sacked in 1985 early in Robert Maxwell's ownership of the Mirror titles. Morgan was fired as editor of the Daily Mirror with immediate effect on 14 May 2004, after refusing to apologize to Sly Bailey, then head of Trinity Mirror, for authorizing the newspaper's publication of photographs which had been shown to be false. These were alleged to show Iraqi prisoners being abused by British Army soldiers from the Queen's Lancashire Regiment when, within days, the photographs were shown to be crude fakes. Under the headline "Sorrywe were hoaxed," the Mirror responded that it had fallen victim to a calculated and malicious hoax and apologized for the publication of the photographs. Post-Mirror Press career in partnership with Matthew Freud, he gained ownership in May 2005, of Press Gazette, a media trade publication together with its cash cow, the British Press Awards, in a deal worth £1. Frontman Morgan was filmed falling off a Segway, breaking three ribs. In 2007, Simon Cowell and others made much of Morgan's previous comment in 2003. In a Mirror headline, after former U.S. President George W. Bush fell off a Segway, "You'd have to be an idiot to fall off, wouldn't you, Mr. Chairman?" of Channel 4 Luke Johnson was reported not to like the program throughout 2006. Morgan appeared as a judge on the television show America's Got Talent alongside Brandi Norwood and David Hasselhoff on NBC. Morgan was chosen by Simon Cowell as a replacement for himself because of the conditions of his American Idol contract. Morgan appeared as a celebrity contestant on Comic Relief as The Apprentice in 2007, to raise money for the BBC charity telethon Comic Relief after his team lost. Morgan was selected by Sir Alan Sugar as the contestant to be fired also in 2007. Morgan appeared as a judge for the second season of America's Got Talent and also appeared as a judge on Britain's Got Talent on ITV. Alongside Amanda Holden and Simon Cowell, he also presented You Can't Fire Me, I'm Famous on BBC One. He fronted a three-part documentary about sandbanks for ITV entitled Piers Morgan on Sandbanks in January 2008. Morgan was the winner of the US celebrity version of The Apprentice. In 2008, he was eventually the overall winner, being named Celebrity Apprentice by host Donald Trump on 27 March, ahead of fellow finalist, American country music star Trace Adkins, and having raised substantially more cash than all the other contestants combined. Morgan signed a two-year Golden Handcuffs deal with ITV in May 2008, reportedly worth £2 million per year as part of the deal. He would continue as a judge on Britain's Got Talent for at least two more series and front a new chat show. He also made some interview specials, plus three more documentaries from various countries. Morgan's Golden Handcuffs deal was the first signing by ITV's new director of television, Peter Fincham, on 8 September 2008. Morgan featured in The Dark Side of Fame with Piers Morgan, produced by BBC Scotland. He returned to ITV in February 2009, with the series, Piers Morgan On, which saw him visit Dubai, Monte Carlo and Hollywood. The series positioned Morgan as a modern-day Alan Wicker and received strong viewing figures for the channel. The program returned for a second series in 2010 when Morgan visited Las Vegas. His show, Piers Morgan's Life Stories, began on ITV in 2009 with Sharon Osbourne as the subject of the first episode. Other guests on the program included Cheryl and the then Prime Minister Gordon Brown. CNN announced on 8 September 2010 that Morgan would replace Larry King in the network's evening lineup with his show, Piers Morgan Live. Beginning on 17 January 2011, the program was cancelled in February 2014 and ended its run in March 2014 after the poor ratings of Piers Morgan Live. CNN announced that the show was to be cancelled, commenting on the viewing figure. Morgan said that he was a British guy debating American cultural issues, including guns, which has been very polarizing, and there is no doubt that there are many in the audience who are tired of me banging on about it. From 13 April to 17 April 2015, Piers guest hosted five episodes of Good Morning Britain on ITV, and from November 2015 as a permanent co-host on Mondays, Tuesdays and Wednesdays. He appears alongside Susanna Reid and Charlotte Hawkins. Feud's Ian Hislop. Morgan appeared as a guest on the satirical news quiz Have I Got News For You in an episode transmitted on 24 May 1996. In it, show regular Ian Hislop accused Morgan of having him followed and having his house watched. The conflict escalated, and at one point the host, Angus Deaton, asked if they wished to go outside and have a fight later on. Guest panelist Clive Anderson confronted Morgan, commenting, "The last time I was rude to you, you sent photographers to my doorstep the next day," to which Piers Morgan retorted, "You won't see them this time." The audience responded loudly in favor of Hislop. "We're about to start exposing the moon-faced midget," Morgan was quoted as saying in 2002, to which Hislop responded, "All he's been offering for information about my private life is a £50 reward. My friends think that's not nearly enough." In 2007, Hislop chose Morgan as one of his pet hates on Room 101. In doing so, Hislop spoke of the history of animosity between himself and Morgan and revealed that after their exchange on Have I Got News For You, which was shown as a clip, Morgan's reporters were tasked with trying to get gossip on Hislop's private life, including phoning acquaintances of Hislop. And photographers were sent in case Hislop did anything untoward or embarrassing while in their presence. Neither the reporters nor the photographers succeeded. Hislop also revealed that Morgan had attempted to quell the feud in an article in the Mail on Sunday, saying, "The war is over. I'm officially calling an end to hostilities. At least from my end, I'm sure it won't stop him carrying on his peers' moron stuff," a reference to the habit of Private Eye, the fortnightly satirical magazine which Hislop edits, referring to Morgan as peers' Morgan moron. Hislop, who had been engaged in work on a World War I documentary at the time, responded by asking, "Is that an armistice or an unconditional surrender?" Although the show's host Paul Merton agreed to put Morgan into Room 101, he was comically rejected as being too toxic, even for Room 101. Jeremy Clarkson. In October 2003, journalist and television personality Jeremy Clarkson reportedly emptied a glass of water over Morgan during the last flight of Concorde in March 2004. At the British Press Awards, Clarkson punched Morgan 3 times in a clash over the Mirror's coverage of his private life, and accusations that Clarkson did not write for his column in The Sun himself. Morgan reported on a rapprochement with Clarkson in the epilogue of his book, Don't You Know Who I Am, Janet Mock. On 4 February 2014, transgender advocate Janet Mock appeared as a guest on Piers Morgan Live to discuss her memoir, Redefining Realness. After the interview aired, Mock sent a series of tweets criticizing Morgan for describing Mock as being formerly a man. Morgan responded that he had never been treated in such a disgraceful manner by a guest on 5 February. Mock appeared as a guest again to debate the dispute banned guests on 28 March 2012. MTV referred to the bad relations between Piers Morgan and Madonna, reporting that Morgan has apparently felt slighted over the years by Madonna. He claims he was lied to by the singer's publicist. In September 2012, it was reported that Morgan had also banned actor Kelsey Grammer. Morgan himself claimed, "Kelsey Grammer saw a photo of his ex-wife Camille in the open of our show and legged it." TV Guide reported, "All plans were still a go for the segment until Grammer actually got in the hot seat and saw the footage the producers had planned to peg to the segment, including a picture of his ex-wife." On 26 September 2012, Fox 11 Los Angeles reported that many say was an ambush by Piers. The Huffington Post reported that before the interview was scheduled, it was made clear that Grammer would answer all questions, including those about his sole request was not to show any images of her, keeping it classy. Grammer doesn't seem at all concerned that he won't be welcome back to Morgan's show, which has been struggling in the ratings on CNN. Morgan also has banned actor Hugh Grant, denigrating Grant on Twitter in May 2011. "Hugh Grant is now banned, in perpetuity, from at Pierce Tonight and anything else I ever do, tedious little man." Phone hacking allegations. During Morgan's tenure as editor, the Daily Mirror was advised by Stephen Knott that voicemail interception was possible by means of a standard PIN code. Despite staff initially expressing enthusiasm for the story, it did not appear in the paper, although it did subsequently feature in a South Wales Argus article and on BBC Radio 5 Live in October 1999. On 18 July 2011, Knott was visited by officers of Operation Weeding. He came under criticism for his boasting about phone hacking from Conservative MP Louise Mensch, who has since apologized for these accusations in July 2011. In a sequence of articles, the political blogger Paul Staines alleged that while editor of the Daily Mirror in 2002, Morgan published a story concerning the affair of Sven-Göran Eriksson and Ulrika Jonsson while knowing it to have been obtained by phone hacking on 20 December 2011, Morgan was a witness by satellite link from the United States at the Leveson inquiry while he said he had no reason to believe that phone hacking had occurred. At the Mirror while he was in charge there, he admitted to hearing a recording of an answerphone message left by Paul McCartney for Heather Mills, but refused to discuss where that tape was played or who made it would compromise a source. Appearing as a witness at the same inquiry on 9 February 2012, Mills was asked under oath if she had ever made a recording of Paul McCartney's phone call or had played it to Piers Morgan. She replied, "Never." She said that she had never authorized Morgan, or anybody, to access or listen to her voicemails. Mills told the Inquiry that Morgan, a man that has written nothing but awful things about me for years, would have relished telling the Inquiry if she had played a personal voicemail message to him on 23 May 2012. Newsnight presenter Jeremy Paxman was a witness at the Leveson Inquiry. He recalled a lunch with the Mirror editor in September 2002 at which Morgan outlined the means of hacking into a mobile phone on 28 November 2012. The Channel 4 documentary Taking on the Tabloids, fronted by actor and phone hacking victim Hugh Grant, showed footage from a 2003 interview with Morgan by the singer and phone hacking victim Charlotte Church, during which he explained to her how to avoid answerphone messages being listened to by journalists. He said, "You can access voicemails by typing in a number now. Are you really telling me that journalists aren't going to do that?" On 29 November 2012, the official findings of the Leveson Inquiry were released, in which Lord Justice Leveson said that Morgan's testimony under oath on phone hacking was utterly unpersuasive. He stated, "Evidence does not establish that authorized the hacking of voicemails or that journalists employed by TMG were indulging in this practice. What it does, however, clearly prove is that he was aware that it was taking place in the press as a whole and that he was sufficiently unembarrassed by what was criminal behavior that he was prepared to joke about it." Wikinews has related news. Piers Morgan interviewed by police investigating phone hacking on 6 December 2013. Morgan was interviewed, under caution, by police officers from Operation Weeding investigating phone hacking allegations at Mirror Group newspapers during his tenure as editor on 24 September 2014. The Trinity Mirror Publishing Group admitted for the first time that some of its journalists had been involved in phone hacking and agreed to pay compensation to four people who sued for the alleged hacking of voicemail. Six other phone hacking claims had already been settled. The BBC reported that it had seen legal papers showing that although the alleged hacking could have taken place as early as 1998, the bulk of the alleged wrongdoing took place in the early 2000s when Morgan was the Daily Mirror editor. The admissions by Trinity Mirror came whilst the London Metropolitan Police investigation into the phone hacking allegations was ongoing. Morgan has always denied any involvement in the practice. Personal life. Morgan married Marion Shallow in 1991 in Hampshire. They have three sons. Morgan and Shallow divorced in 2008, and he remarried. His second wife is Celia Walden, a newspaper columnist and feature writer, and daughter of the former Conservative MP George Walden. Morgan claims to be a fan of Premier League football club Arsenal FC. He has been an outspoken critic of the entire club, including Arsenal manager Arsene Wenger, on social media and on the radio, and has called for his sacking. Arsenal goalkeeping legend Bob Wilson, in defense of Wenger, labeled Morgan a pompous individual. When Arsenal midfielder Aaron Ramsey met Morgan on 26 April 2015, Ramsey refused to shake his hand due to the criticism he received from Morgan during the 2012-13 season. Morgan has responded by calling Ramsey "What's his name?" Morgan is a Roman Catholic. Books. Morgan, Piers, John Sachs, 1991. Secret Lives. Blake. ISBN. U.S. Editor-at-Large. The Guardian retrieved 13 January 2015. Carrot. Davies, Hunter, 13 December 1994, From City Boy to World Leader. The Independent retrieved 7 February 2012. Magazine, 9 October 2011. Carrot. A.B. Summerskill, Ben, 1 September 2002, Has Piers Now Got News for Ian? The Observer retrieved 13 January 2015. Carrot. Jagger, Susie, Mirror Editor, Saw His Shares Soar After Paper Tipped Company. The Daily Telegraph, archived from the original on 22 November 2002, retrieved 13 January 2015. Gazette Deal, Journalismcalc. 2007. Carrot. Conlon, Tara, 29 May 2008. Piers Morgan, Britain's Got Talent Judge Signs 2-Year Deal with ITV. The Guardian retrieved 8 June 2008. Media Spy, 9 September 2010, retrieved 9 September 2010. Carrot. What a Moron, Private Eye, 20 December 2014, retrieved 13 January 2015. September 2012, retrieved 30 September 2012. Carrot. Official Facebook page, Fox 11 Flash, 26 September 2012, retrieved 30 September 2012. Carrot. Kelsey Grammer, Piers Morgan, Actor Bard, Huffington Post, 27 September 2012, retrieved 30 September 2012. Carrot. Perricone, Kathleen, 17 May 2011, Piers Morgan bans Hugh Grant from CNN talk show, calls the actor a tedious little man. Daily News, New York, retrieved January 11, 2013. Carrot A. B. Michael Holden, the 9th of February 2012. Beatles ex-wife says Piers Morgan heard hacked call. Reuters. The 29th of September 2014. Carrot A. B. BBC News Online. Phone hacking. Trinity Mirror admits liability. BBC News Online. The 24th of September 2014. Retrieved the 29th of September 2014. Carrot Piers Morgan marries Celia Walden. The Daily Telegraph. The 25th of June 2010. Wikinews has news related to Piers Morgan. Piers Morgan on Twitter. Piers Morgan at the Internet Movie Database profile. Piers Morgan BBC News, the 14th of May 2004. Desert Island Discs. Desert Island Discs, the 7th of June 2009. BBC Radio 4. Succeeded. 1960, John Bevan. 1962, Sidney Jacobson. The Sunday. 1964, Sidney Jacobson. 1965, Dick Dinsdale. 1969, Larry Lamb. 1972, Bernard Shrimsley. 1975, Larry Lamb. 1981, Kelvin McKenzie. 1994, Stuart Higgins. 1998, David Yellen. 2003, Rebecca Wade. 2009, Dominic Mohan. 2013, David Deansmore. 2015, Tony Gallagher. News of the World. World 1843, Henry Drake Brune. 1891, Emsley Carr. 1941, David Percy Davies. 1946, Robert Skelton. 1947, Arthur Waters. 1953, Reg Cudlip. 1960, Stafford Summerfield. 1970, Cyril Lear. 1974, Peter Stevens. 1975, Bernard Shrimsley. 1980, Kenneth Donlan. 1981, Barry Askew. 1981, Derek Jameson. 1984, Nicholas Lloyd. 1985, David Montgomery. 1987, Wendy Henry. 1988, Patsy Chapman. 1993, Stuart Higgins. 1994, Piers Morgan. 1995, Phil Hall. 2000, Rebecca Wade. 2003, Andy Coulson. 2007, Colin Myler. VE editors of the Daily Mirror, Sunday Mirror and Sunday Pictorial. Daily Mirror 1903, Mary Howarth. 1904, Hamilton Fife. 1907, Alexander Kenealy. 1915, Ed Flynn. 1916, Alexander Campbell. 1931, Lee Brownlee. 1934, Cecil Thomas. 1948, Sylvester Bolam. 1953, Jack Nenner. 1961, Lee Howard. 1971, Tony Miles. 1974, Michael Christensen. 1975, Mike Malloy. 1985, Richard Stott. 1990, Roy Greenslade. 1991, Richard Stott. 1992, David Banks. 1994, Colin Myler. 1995, Piers Morgan. 2004, Richard Wallace. 2012, Lloyd Emley. Sunday Pictorial. 1915, F. R. Sanderson. 1921, William McWhirter. 1924, David Grant. 1928, William McWhirter. 1929, David Grant. 1938, Hugh Cudlip. 1940, Stuart Campbell. 1946, Hugh Cudlip. 1949, Phil Zeck. 1952, Hugh Cudlip. 1953, Colin Valdar. 1959, Lee Howard. 1961, Reg Payne. Sunday Mirror. 1963, Michael Christensen. 1972, Bob Edwards. 1984, Peter Thompson. 1986, Mike Malloy. 1988, Eve Pollard. 1991, Bridget Rowe. 1992, Colin Myler. 1994, Paul Kanu. 1995, Tessa Hilton. 1996, Amanda Plattel. 1997, Bridget Rowe. 1998, Brendan Parsons. 1998, Colin Myler. 2001, Tina Weaver. 2012, Lloyd Emley. VE The Apprentice U.S. List of Candidates. Seasons Regular 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 0 Celebrity 7, 8, 9, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3 All-Stars 14, 15 Winners Regular Bill Rancic, Kelly Perdue, Kendra Todd, Randall Pinkett, Sean Yasbick, Stephanie Sheffer Celebrity Piers Morgan. Joan Rivers, Brett Michaels, John Rich, Arsenio Hall, Trace Adkins, Lisa Gibbons. Related programs: The Celebrity Apprentice, The Apprentice, Martha Stewart, VE America's Got Talent Seasons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.